Welcome back. We're in the midst of a pretty good game right now. This is a make-or-break situation for our champion, Tina. Tina's got some guards to work her way through right now, and Clay's putting the heat on her, as they say in this business. And let's get on to our third question. Tina, we surveyed 100 college men who belong to a fraternity, and we asked them, well, this is pretty serious. If you wanted to buy illegal drugs, would you know who to call? How many fraternity men said they would know who to call?
Oh, that one is real high. There's a lot of that going on nowadays, especially at my campus. That's going to be about 85 out of 100.
85 out of 100.
They're easy to get now.
85 out of 100.
Definitely.
Well, Clay, what do you say?
I'm a member of Lambda Chi, and I think most of them are really nice guys, and I think they've learned over the years that drugs just aren't good for you, and so I'm going to say it's lower.
You're going to say it's lower. Excuse me, I want to see this myself. The actual number of fraternity men who would know who to call for illegal drugs is... It is 85!
Oh,
it is exactly 85!
Oh, wow.
You got it right on the money.
Oh,
and because you got it right on the money, you win $500. Put out your hand. One, two, three, four, five. There you go. There you go, Tina. Excellent. All right, Tina, you have a decision to make. You got the high-low question correct, then you can change this card
if you want,
but you got an excellent card.
I want to play it out. I feel lucky now that I have this many in my hands, and I want to keep that card, and I want to go higher.
Higher than a three. A seven.
Okay. Oh. I'm going to play it. I want to go higher.
Higher than a seven. A king.
Oh, lower. Lower, lower, lower.
Lower than a king. A deuce.
Oh.
Higher than a deuce, just ties up the match. A nine. Whoa. Whoa. Way to go. You were lucky. You were lucky. Congratulations. $500 brought you luck. You now have $100 more. You've won one game. And we now have to face the tiebreaker. And Lacey's dealing out the cards right now for the tiebreaker. We always play the tiebreaker with three cards and a maximum of three questions. Clay, goes to you, sir. Boy, it got quiet. We surveyed 100 married women, and we asked them, during a tender moment with your husband, have you ever closed your eyes and pretended you were in the arms of another man? How many married women admitted they have?
Oh, I think sexual fantasies are pretty much a part of everybody, and even a married woman would do that, especially after several years. So I'm going to say that's a reasonably high number. Probably 65.
65? You're saying 65 out of 100.
Oh, this is a hard...
What do you say, Tina?
Oh, I can see myself closing my eyes and wishing it was Tom Selleck, but hey, I think that, oh, it's going to be higher.
You're going to go higher.
A little bit higher. Everybody has to wonder.
Okay. Everybody has to wonder. The actual number of married women who have closed their eyes and pretended they were in the arms of another man is... 46, it isn't higher, it's lower. It's lower. So, Clay, you get the shot at the cards over here, sir. Here's your base card. Take a look at it. Tell me what you want to do. A 10. You can change it if you want.
I'll change it.
You're going to change it? That 10 now becomes a 7.
Oh.
Right in the middle now. Right in the middle.
I'm going to have to go higher.
You're going
to
go higher than a 7. A 7. Oh. It is not higher than the 7. That means that... Tina gets a free shot at the cards,
I'm
and let's
ready.
See what you're playing from, Tina.
Okay.
You're playing from the 9.
Okay, I want to go lower than the 9.
Lower than a 9.
Okay,
a 5.
Higher than a 5.
Higher than a 5.
Higher.
For the game and the match.
Can I bring me luck?
A 6. Ah! It is higher. The champ came out. Whoa.
Oh, my God.
Terrific. Terrific. Just terrific. Pulled it out of the fire. Okay. Tina's won it. Clay, you're an able challenger.
Well,
it was
thank
so
you
nice
very much.
Having you.
Thank you.
I wish you good luck back in Arkansas.
Thank
You've got some lovely party gifts backstage. You've won $100. Come on, Tina. Come on over here. It's fine on Mark. You are $100 richer. You now have $200 in your pocket. More important than that, you're going to get to play the money cards, and you can just win thousands of dollars there. You know that. So let's have Lacey and Susanna come out here and deal from a new deck of cards. You're going to be playing the money cards. Let's tell you how to do that. You know how to do that. Let's tell the folks at home.
Okay.
The $200 you've already won is yours to keep. We're going to give you some new money to bet with. We're going to give you $200, start you out at the bottom line. You must bet your way across that line, calling high and low. When we get to the second line, we're going to give you an additional $400 of betting money. You bet your way across that line. Minimum bets are $50 until we get to the top line. That's the big bet line where you must wager at least half your dollars. Don't forget, you will have an opportunity to change one card on each line by selecting one of the spare cards that Susanna is dealing out right now. That's all there is to it. You ready to do it?
Oh, you know it. I have my lucky $500.
You're
right
not
here.
In bad shape at all. Let's give her $200. You got it. $200 could turn into $32,000 if you play it right. Here's the base card. Let's see what it is. A 9.
Okay, I want to change it to start out with, and I want number 2. Please.
You want number 2?
2.
You can have it. Let's make a better card. Here it is, a 10.
Okay.
A little bit of help.
Okay.
$200 on the 10.
I want to get $100 lower than the 10.
$100 lower than a 10. A queen. Ooh.
Here I go again.
Okay, you lost 100. You've got 100 to bet with. Good card
okay,
to play
well, for. Now I want to bet $100 that it's lower than the queen.
$100 lower than
it.
A queen. A 7.
Okay.
$200. All
right.
Playing on the 7.
I want to bet $50 that it's higher than the 7.
$50 higher than a 7. A deuce. Not higher than a 7.
Okay.
You have $150 right now. I'm going to give you $400 additional betting money to go with. You have $550 playing off a 2.
Okay, I want all of it higher than that 2.
All of it higher than the
it's
2.
It's gotta be.
A 5.
Okay.
$1,100.
I want to bet $600 that it's higher than the 5.
$600 higher than a 5. A 4. Ooh.
Okay,
ooh,
what's
back,
the deal here?
You're back to $500 playing off the 4.
Okay, that's okay. I want to bet $400 that it's higher than the 4.
$400 higher than a 4. A queen.
Okay.
$900.
Here we go.
$900. We go up to the top line. You must wager at least $450 if you want to keep the card.
Oh, I want all of it lower.
All of it lower than a queen.
I'm gambling.
A jack.
Yeah!
$1,800. You know how to play the cards. You do. You know how to play the cards. You've now got $9,000 in your pocket. Who knows where this young lady can go? We'll be right back right after this commercial message.